Hey there, YouTubers!
Thanks for tuning in. We just wrapped up a Facebook Live where we chatted all things Mod Podge and glitter. Plus, we're sharing 20 different ideas for making summer fun projects with glitter.
So subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and take a look at the video. Hey everybody, welcome to our Facebook Live. I'm Steve Piacenza.
And I'm Kathy Fillion. And if this is your first time joining us for our Mod Podge Facebook Live, thank you so much. And if we are welcoming you back, and you've seen our Facebook Lives or YouTube show, we are so grateful to have you back joining us.
Okay, you guys might be wondering why we're holding two gigantic ice cream cones, and it has to do with the cone part of it, because today, it's all about no-mess glitter, and these two ice cream cones were made with the new Mega Glitter, and we're going to be showing you that in gold, and we also have hologram and silver, these three formulas, but we're going to be showing you five today with a bunch of cool projects that we used it on.
We've got 20 plus summer fun ideas, all using the different Mod Podge glitter formulas.
Yes.
Plus, we've got some scoop.
No pun intended. This isn't a comedy show, Kat.
We've got some scoop on National Mod Podge Day,
yes,
which is May. It's May 1st today.
All month is Mod Podge Day, yeah.
We've got Mod Podge Day on May 18th, and Plaid is going to have a bunch of different giveaways via Instagram, and we're going to share that info with you in just a little bit, but it's going to be fabulous.
Yeah.
And all month long, there will be different live streams on Facebook and different stories on Instagram with all the different Mod Podge scoop. It's very exciting.
Very exciting. We want to see some of your photos, but we're going to tell you about that in a little bit. Why don't we get rid of these ice cream cones and begin?
So we want to start with our newest formula, which is the Mod Podge Mega Glitter. And look at that glitter. Steve said earlier, no mess glitter, and we're not kidding about it.
Because this is what I always do. This is the big test. Nothing. That is what the cool thing is about this stuff.
So the Mega Glitter is the newest of the Mod Podge formulas, and it comes in three different colorways. We've got gold, hologram, which works over any color, so it's almost like it's a sparkly pastel color that works great over all different colors. And in addition, we have silver. So silver, gold, and hologram. Now this formula is the most glittery formula. So you'll recognize the bottle when you're at the store. And you can find this at plaidonline.com. And if you look in the link below, it's got all sorts of scoop on National Mod Podge Day, and you can find everything about Mod Podge at Plaid. That's got the super sparkly label like that. And again, it's gold, hologram, and silver. Brand new formula. It's got two sizes of glitter, so it's going to be your mega, really super sparkly formula.
And we're also going to be showing you Mod Podge Extreme Glitter, which is right down here. It's an ultra fine glitter. And we're going to show you the sparkle formula right over here. So these are all, they're all a little bit different, and we're gonna be explaining that throughout our Facebook Live, and you're gonna see all different projects and the different looks that they all give you.
So we'll get started with the gold, because right now I am personally gold obsessed. And I'm not talking real
She's
gold.
She's glitter obsessed.
I'm glitter gold obsessed.
Come on.
So this is the gold formula. We made some sample boards just to show you guys what it's going to look like. And Raphael's here with us today working the camera. So if you have questions, you can right away. I don't know if we can get to them live because Facebook's been a little bit tricky. But go ahead and post them and we will get back to you. Can you catch the light with that? So that's the super, that's the mega gold. And I want to show you what it looks like in the jar. So with this one, you're either going to stir it up, or I like to give it just kind of a little twist up and down. You don't want to shake it too much, kind of roll it around or use a skewer to stir it. And you can already see in the lid how chunky that is. And it looks kind of like an old gold color, but all of the part that's the Mod Podge will dry clear. So you're just left with that really sparkly gold. And it goes on super great. It's thicker. It's thicker than most of your formulas. Look at that. And you just brush it right onto your project.
Yeah, we're hoping that, you know, the camera shows one thing, but here live in front of us,
so
this
sparkly
stuff is so sparkly, and it's super intense, and it's just loaded with glitter.
Oh yeah, I mean, look at my brush. In fact,
Yeah, we
have a little brush tip.
You have to wash these things, soak them in water, because if you move on to another project, there's so much glitter in this stuff, your brushes are going to be full of the color you used before.
So I like to soak it in a little water and then give it a good wash.
Yeah.
And you do want to go ahead and seal up your bottle when you're in between working with it. I want to show you what the differences between coats and what the differences between undercoats are when you're working with gold. So this is the gold over white. And this is what one coat over white looks like. And it's beautiful. You get that light kind of, well, you did a project in silver where you really can see how it creates like a dusting of glitter. And then this is three coats. So you can see the difference there.
And you know what's great about this stuff? Even the one coat, it's like when you brush it on, you get this even amount. It almost does it itself. So you can move the glitter around a little bit, but when you are brushing it on, it really distributes very evenly, which is nice.
Oh yeah, very simple. And if you can look closely there, you can see those different sizes of glitter in there. And that's what really makes the Mega Glitter different, is that you've got large chunks mixed with ultra fine. And I think that's what's so superior about this, because it really creates a nice, beautiful coverage.
It's almost like chopped up gold leaf.
Oh yeah, yeah. And I want to show you, this is really cool too. So I like to base coat when I'm working with this. You've got here a yellow base coat. That's one coat over yellow. You could go with a darker gold if you wanted to. One coat over white. And then this is just stunning. One coat over black. It's almost like
galactic.
Oh, yeah, galactic.
Space.
Or in like kind of gold leaf, like a different look for that.
Yeah.
So that's what those look like. Now, Mega Glitter, what is it going to work on? It's going to work on all sorts of things. All your regular surfaces, canvas, wood.
Glass. Terracotta.
Now, with the glass, we should go there first. With the glass, this is going to be not dishwasher safe. So just hand wash safe. And this glass started out like this. Oh yeah, here's a ceramic. So you can see a ceramic and glass both.
Beautiful.
Such a really fun way to just make it, you know, custom pieces. I've gone ahead and taped it off. Now, can you open this one for me? Thank you. So I've taped off this sort of geometric design just because I want to do something a little bit different. And one thing that's important is you don't want to put this where the lip will go. So it's a good idea to start this a little bit lower than a lip line. And just for sake of time, we have gone ahead and rubbed this clean with rubbing alcohol, and you want to do that before you get started. And I like to start on the tape if I'm doing glassware and work my way this way. That way I'm getting that nice, crisp edge. And that crisp edge is right there. That's what I'm talking about. You want that crisp edge.
That's what you're talking about. Yes.
You know I like I have all my little tricks I like to do. So you just start like that, and that'll create that crisp edge. And then you can go in and start really kind of dabbing it and filling it in.
And let's let you guys know that, you know what, this is, what do we do, three coats on this one?
That is three coats.
This is three coats. So if this is a nice dusting of it, so you can stop whenever you want. So you can kind of see how things look, because this is a beautiful dusting of it with, you can kind of see it through the glass. This is three coats, so you can kind of stop when you want, one coat, up to five coats, completely solid.
Now, important to note, though, is you are going to need about 2 hours, 1 to 2 hours dry time in between coats.
In between, definitely.
If you don't, now I'm just going to show you, you wouldn't want to do this, but if you don't and it's not dry and you go to put another coat on, you could risk smearing your glitter up like that. So you really want a nice, long dry time in between. That's for all the Mega Glitters.
That's for all the Mega Glitters. And also 28 days for it to completely cure.
On glass.
On glass before you want to wipe it down with water.
Yeah, before you hand wash, for sure. So, and a lot of people are doing stemware like this for parties, weddings, you know, toasting glasses, that kind of thing.
Yeah, I think you need to put these on, though.
Oh.
Yeah, well, you just said it's such a cute idea for Mother's Day, which is...
Mother's Day,
oh,
yeah.
All these projects are for Mother's... Yes, holidays, Mother's Day.
Teacher appreciation.
We're even seeing a little baby shower. Well, we'll get to these in a minute. Hold on. We don't want to get ahead of ourselves.
Here are some... These were some cheapy glasses, and we used the Mega Gold glitter on those and gave a kind of a little bit of a... fun look there with those bows. Those are some resin bows.
Let's see the man, you movie star. Look at that. Look good.
I think these are super cute. Now, another fashion idea, because of course glitter and fashion is like, you know, this is just this fun baseball hat. So Mega Glitter is going to work on fabric, but it's not going to be washable. So if you have home decor projects like toss pillows that maybe are seasonal, or a lampshade or things like that, artwork, of course, like the artwork we showed you at the beginning. Any of those types of projects for the home or for fashion will be fine. Like this baseball cap, because I'm not going to wash this. You know, I just want to have something fun for this summer. So I want to show you how to do that. Where's my gold?
There's your brush.
Oh, he closed it up.
So, well, you do want to close it up, you know, so
yeah,
it doesn't start to dry
exactly
out.
Absolutely. So let's go ahead and just show you how that works. Again, it's super thick formula, and you can just brush it right on.
And again, look at how even that distributes. That's what I was talking about earlier.
So you just go right up to the edge there, and you just brush it on. I like to go a couple different directions. And the hat is two coats. So the hat was just two coats. And look at how sparkly that is with two coats.
Put them next to each other, they can see.
That's one, and then that's two.
Yeah.
But what's really cool is you don't have to worry about getting glitter in your eye, because it's no mess. Yeah. There's no flake off, no nothing.
My favorite part of this whole
thing. And we did some cute baby shoes. These were just some canvas shoes. This is great if you need a quick gift for a baby shower. And this was three coats on there. And then we just used some fabric glue to attach that fun trim there. I really love it for home decor. Anyone who's watched us over the years knows that we love dollar store makeovers. And we found these fun little plain pineapples at the dollar store. And we gave them a facelift just by adding that gold glitter all around there. Look how sparkly that is.
And here's another great Mother's Day project.
Oh, I love this. So this is like super, like if you're into what's fun about the glitter is you could do romantic looking projects. You can do modern poppy projects. Really, whatever your style is, you can incorporate the mega glitters into your style. So look at that. We just did a real modern kind of look there on this romantic frame. Really fun, quick artwork that you can do.
Inexpensive frame, dollar store frame. It just adds, it bumps it up to something a little bit more fancy.
So that is our gold formula. And I think we're ready to take a look
at
silver.
Let's do silver. Now, all that explanation that Kathy just gave applies exactly the same to the silver as far as the dry times and the brush strokes and all that. But it's a different color. I love silver. And as you can see, Raphael, if you want to grab that and get it into the light. Show that silver. It's a gigantic pop of color. We want to show you the difference now between the three coat and the one coat on the silver. There it is, three coats and the one coat. You can see that right there. And we also did base coats also. We did a gray, a white, and a black, just to show you guys the difference between the three. So these each have one coat on them with different base coat colors, which really you can, you know, again, with your projects, whatever you're doing, you can kind of see how different it looks with each color. And we have some of these projects here that we did. Again, like we said, teacher appreciation, Mother's Day coming up. These are great gifts for that. Here's a dollar store vase, or if you have old vases in your house that have been around for a long time, you want to spruce them up a little bit, you can base coat them whatever color you want. This one's a gray, and we added one coat of the Mod Podge Mega Silver right on top of that.
And this, I think this is a great example of how you can, if you want to get that whispery look of glitter, you just do that one coat.
This
you
is
don't
the,
have
yeah.
to necessarily go for the really chunky.
Right, that's what we're saying. Go to one coat. You want to add more, two coats, three coats, or completely solid.
And just make sure with the mega glitter you have a decent dry time in between.
Definitely. Here is the mega glitter. No mess mega glitter. Okay, I can't express that enough. Look, it does not come off. That's the beauty of this stuff.
And when you're working with it, you're not sprinkling glitter on your project. It's all embedded in the Mod Podge formula.
So this is a great little holiday project. Again, we say dollar store all the time, but it's true. It's like this was a little dollar vase and we just put it, you know, made it a 4th of July, a holiday, you know, festivities.
Well,
it's going to be on tables, the picnics, Christmas, Easter, all different holidays. You can use this stuff on.
Well, I think really all of these glitter formulas work for so many different holiday decor and everybody crafts for the
holidays. What about this for teachers?
I love
it. Won't this be great?
Except for I think you need to stuff a Starbucks gift card.
Exactly.
All the teachers I know want gift cards.
So we just did the lid on this. Again, it just brings it up another level. Kind of looks way cooler than if it was just the plain tin lid. Just mega glitter. This is about three coats on top of that. It's a great little
gift.
Well,
and so many people, like there's if you're doing bridesmaids or, I mean, just there's endless ideas for these types of little gifts. And it's true. A lot of people will do mason jar gifts and then stick a little something in it. So it might be a couple of tea bags or what are those little... Steve loves these little things that you add to your water, those drippy things.
Oh, yeah, those, like, we can't say brand names, but the little powders. You know, you have the powders? Yeah.
You can take these jars and fill them up with something. You could fill them up with hot cocoa mixes, all kinds of things. God,
great gift ideas. Okay, now, here we go.
People had some questions about sealing it. Are you guys using anything to seal it? Or
no, that's the beauty of it.
It's you can, all
it's,
sealed.
It's all one step. So yeah. You just brush it on, let it dry in between. Couple hours dry in between, and then just keep coating it until you're, you know, you have the look that you want, and then you just let it dry overnight.
Now, if you were doing something, maybe like a piece of furniture or something, you know, you might want to seal it with something, but it's really not necessary,
yeah.
Especially for these small things.
Not these projects.
It's
yeah.
All embedded, so the Mod Podge and the glitter are all together, so it works as the sealer and the coat all in one.
Yeah, there it is. There it is. That's what it, the way it looks. It's a little bit foggy. Let's show you guys a little bit of this. So if you can see that, it looks a little bit milky, and that's the you know, the Mod Podge itself. And it's gonna dry completely clear of that and just add the glitter right on top. So you can go one direction. Like this. And then what I like to do is, once you have your first coat down, your second coat, let that dry for a couple hours, and then you're going to move in the opposite direction and go across this way. That way it's completely sealed.
And that really helps distribute the glitter evenly.
Yeah. Even though it does it very well on its own, it's good to go one direction, let it dry, and then go the opposite direction.
And that's like the brush-on way. You can also tap it on, which shows Steve's going to show you.
Okay, how I got stuck with this project, I'm not sure.
The earrings.
But here's some earrings. So, again, and it's very, very, very super inexpensive earrings. Now, Kathy did, I did the Mega Glitter, and Kathy added, punched some holes and added these little dangles on the bottom here. And I'm going to show you just another little technique, how we did this. We're going to add... Let's get that right in there. We're gonna add this Mega Glitter right on top. Now, as you can see, if you were to brush it on, that's kind of what it looks like, and it'll give you a nice thin layer of that. But what we did with these, we tapped it on. So when you tap it on, it's gonna add that Mega Glitter right on top, and don't worry about the bumps because it all levels out when it dries. So you're gonna add 2 to 3 coats of this. Again, if you want some of that copper popping through, once it dries, take a look at it. You like it, you leave it alone. You want it full, like what we did here, you just keep adding the Mega Glitter right on top. Just get a little bit more over that.
And you're going to want this type of project to dry flat, but if you have vases and things that are upright, it's no big deal. It doesn't really drip off.
Yeah. So that would be my first coat. Just like that. And then it will flatten out a little bit, and then I would add another layer, and it would fill in all in between that.
So you can really do some fun, you know, trendy ideas. That was just a real inexpensive metal base.
Mm-hmm.
You can easily turn them into earrings.
Yeah.
Trendy earrings.
Trendy earrings. Okay.
It's all about the trends, right?
What else we got going on? We got... That's the silver. I believe
uh-huh.
We're done with the silver. We got all our projects going.
Yeah. Now, we got one more silver look.
Let's see.
We always are talking about.
Oh, yes.
Well, now that I have the girls. It's
how can
like
I forget?
Party central all the time.
Yeah.
So this charger we did with the silver. We base coated it with gray folk art multi-surface paint first. And then we did all that silver on there. And you can see we kind of left. We did 2 coats only because we wanted a little bit of that gray coming through.
Hmm. You know what's happening to these after this Facebook Live is over.
They'll be in Steve's belly.
That's right.
So that is our cupcake platter. Now the next one I want to show you about is the Mod Podge Mega Glitter Hologram. Hologram is the same. It's going to have the different sizes of glitter in there. So you're going to see big chunky pieces and then that ultra fine behind there. I hope you guys can see how sparkly that is. One of the cool things about hologram, or AB, some people call it, is that, or Aurora Borealis, is it's going to pick up the color that is behind it. So it's going to be really cool if you're working with pastels and whites, and it's amazing over black. So that is our Mega Glitter Hologram. Let me see if I can grab a bottle of it. Here we go. You can see that's got the white label there with a sort of chunky glitter look. And open that up and get a peek. See how that is.
Loaded with that glitter again.
And this is what one coat is going to look like over here. And then we have three coats on the other side. So depending upon the look you're going for, you just want to keep adding those layers. If you're doing wedding stuff, sometimes just one light dusting of something is really pretty. Or if you're doing something maybe for a girl's bedroom, like this unicorn, you might want a really glittery look. So this has got like two coats on it. It's really your personal preference. And I want to show you what it looks like over different colors. So this is over a baby pink. You can see how now that glitter is really picking up all those pink undertones. And this is over white, so you're going to get more of a real sparkly look there. And then this is my favorite, is over the black. It's so galactic looking. So Steve had made those earrings with all the silver. And I want to show you another earring makeover. So these were those same simple hoops. And we did this sort of galactic look. But instead of doing the kind of tap method like Steve showed you with the silver, I just did the fine brush on. Yeah. And that creates that really fine look. That's one coat of just finely brushed on there.
And that's how the black comes through, because you only did the one coat. And that's what that would look like if we kept it just one coat.
Because I wanted to have it almost look like a starry, you know, night sky. Now, if you're into cosplay or costume design or anything like that, even kids' party costumes, these formulas are really fun to alter, you know, inexpensive accessories or jewelry items that you might have in your old junk drawer. You can really jazz them up quite quickly with these formulas. And the unicorn, of course, unicorns are so trendy, but this unicorn, we just, it started out as paper mache. I don't know if you all have seen, there's tons of these paper mache things now at the store in all sorts of awesome trendy things. Mm-hmm. So it's just started out as this brown paper mache, of course, in this shape, and we painted it with the Folk Art multi-surface in white, and then two coats of that glitter over there. And it's just, you know, it's just as easy. You can't even really probably see on camera, but you can just smear it around. You don't even have to be real precise about it. If you wanted to add more chunks in an area, you could do a, you know, a thick daub like that and let that dry. And we used gold on our unicorn horn there. So simple.
Huge transformation.
I'm keeping this. I'm going to hang it in the girls' room. This one.
Like, you could have it.
I want.
Yes. Very good.
So cute.
What do I want? I know what I want, but we're going to talk about those a little bit later. Should we move on to extreme glitter? Okay, so now we're going to be talking about extreme glitter. This is Mod Podge Extreme Glitter. Now, this is ultra fine glitter. So we're out of the megas, but let's just do a quick little recap just to show you guys. We have the silver. We have the hologram, and we have the gold. So those are the three that we just talked about.
In mega.
In the mega.
Now, one important note is that the mega and in all those colorways, that's the glass-friendly formula,
yes.
And that's the fabric-friendly formula. So the new formulas that we're moving into are more for wood, paper, those types of surfaces, metal tip, all your regular Mod Podge surfaces.
Yeah, good point. Absolutely. So here's the extreme glitter. Now, this is a great formula for sealing any type of project, adding that ultra fine glitter. This is hologram also. And I want to just point out, this is it on white. So as you can see that hologram look. But what's really great about this stuff is when you base coat it, whatever color you're going to be base coating in, we did a purple, you can see how it picks up that purple. So if you were to do browns or oranges or yellows, it picks up that color that you're base coating with. That's why we love this. And we have a nice little project over here that we did. This is our Hello Project, and I'm sure you've seen in the craft stores also, they have all these wood letters, they have the wood sayings, and we just did a base coat of this turquoise, and we added the extreme glitter right on top of that. This is just one coat, and it really picks up that color behind it, and it makes for a really nice project. Just adds a nice little touch to that.
And I think that's what's so cool too, is like with the extreme glitter and when we get to sparkle, for home decor, sometimes you don't want a lot of splash and glitter like you might get with the mega glitters, where with these you're going to just get that really soft look.
We have another project, but I think it fell behind. Hold on one minute.
Oh my gosh.
We lost the project. It fell in the cracks back there.
That's okay. I got a ton of paper.
You know what? You can show that on the ice cream cone when we got there. We also did it on, just really quick, I'll explain it. You can do this on top of scrapbook paper, any type of scrapbook paper or paper project. You can add little hints of that.
Well, I'm going to show on the cupcake topper.
I know. It fell behind there. I know it did. Okay.
So now we have 19 projects.
Now we have 19 projects. Okay. This is what I gotta say. This is the no mess glitter. I love this stuff because it is no mess and it doesn't get on your hands. It doesn't get all over. Because as we know, everybody has glitter in their craft room, and this is the stuff. You either love it or you hate it. So there's no two ways about it.
It is definitely messy.
It is definitely messy, and this is what these formulas don't do. They do not give you the mess, which we love. But
well, and I will say with the hologram formulas, either extreme or sparkle or mega, sometimes you want a different color underneath it. You don't want gold or silver.
True.
You want blue, you want pink, you want yellow.
True.
And so you're only going to be using loose glitter.
Yes.
Or paint.
We are very intense about our glitter talks here. But yes, that is absolutely true.
Even literally Delilah and Sophia have gone to school with glitter on their faces, and they're like, oh, the teacher, were you doing glitter projects today? No, mommy was. It's all over the house.
Well, let's talk about it then. Okay, here it is. So, you know, the two work very well together. So what we've done is, my favorite project, we got our little dinosaurs, dollar store, right? So we added our Mod Podge directly onto the dinosaur. You can use your matte or your gloss, and then you sprinkle onto your dinosaur. We've all done this before. You let that dry. Once it's dry, we add the extreme glitter on top of that to seal it. Now, what that does, these can be given away as birthday gifts, at birthday parties, and it does not come off. In addition to that, what it does is, this is just turquoise, but as you can see, once you added the extreme glitter, it gives that hologram look. Mm-hmm. There's different colors in that now, and it seals it. There is no glitter coming off of that. So now they're totally kid-friendly. It's not going to be a big mess.
Well, and if you're doing like party decor or something, you don't want the glitter flaking off everywhere.
Yeah.
Now, if you wanted to just have the blue color and not have that hologram effect, you could always seal any glitter project with your Mod Podge gloss.
Yeah.
And that's going to create a shiny, glossy finish. But to me, I love...
This is pretty, but this adds it. It's a whole new dimension.
And you can see, like on this purple one, with the AB, with the hologram, you've got a little bit more of the purple popping through. When you've got this sort of raspberry pink color, you've got more of that popping through. So depending upon what color is under there, the hologram is really going to bring that color to life.
So you keep the unicorn, I'm keeping these guys.
I love it.
All right.
So next we want to talk about Sparkle Mod Podge. And Sparkle Mod Podge, so this is the hierarchy. Did we go over the hierarchy? Mega Glitter has the most glitter.
Extra
Extreme is the next. And Sparkle has the least amount, although it's still super sparkly. Look at how sparkly that is. So this is the sparkle over a baby pink color. And this is the sparkle over white. So if you want just a light amount of sparkle, ultra fine glitter, hologram, you go with the sparkle. If you want the next level up, you go with extreme. And if you want the most, you go with mega. So sparkle has always been near and dear to my heart. It's one of my favorite formulas since the very beginning of time. So this really works great as a top coat. I personally don't really like to use it as a glue because I feel like it gets a little bit of texture underneath your project because it does have glitter in it. So if you're going to use it as a top coat, we've got this cute popsicle design here because it's all about summer fun. Mm-hmm. So here's our popsicle. And that just started out as this cool kind of watercolor tie-dye melty paper, scrapbook paper. And we Mod Podged it down, added our Sparkle Mod Podge on top of there, one coat, and then we painted this cute kind of drippy chocolate sauce with multi-surface folk art paint. And to do that, you're gonna start with your chipboard base, like this, of a popsicle. And then we've gone ahead and pre-cut our paper to fit. And this is gonna be a two-step process. We're just gonna add, this is our Mod Podge satin formula. You can use satin, matte, it doesn't matter, gloss. I just like satin. And by the way, satin is now coming in a larger bottle. So we're gonna add that to the back. Now, I know we said we were gonna talk to you guys about how to enter these fun giveaways.
Oh, yes.
So.
We're gonna send a photo to Instagram.
Yep, so May 18th is National Mod Podge Day.
Yeah.
And the month, all month long.
All month long, and you wanna send a photo to Instagram and hashtag it National Mod Podge Day.
So every week, Plaid is going to be giving away Mod Podge prize packs. So you make sure you put that on your Instagram page, tag it with National Mod Podge Day, and then you'll be notified via Instagram
yes.
from Plaid if you're a winner. Now, this is only open to U.S. residents.
Yes.
See, I coated both sides. Now I'm going to place that down, and then starting from the center out, just smooth that down, just like so. On this design, we had pre-painted this just kind of a popsicle color. So go ahead and just smooth that down. Now I want to show you how you use this as a top coat. For sake of time, I'm going to go ahead and do it. Normally, I wouldn't do this right away. I would wait about 15 minutes and let that dry up on the base to avoid wrinkles. But I'm going to go ahead and start. This is the sparkle formula. It's very different than the Mega Glitters. Look how it looks almost white. Looks thin. Very different, much thinner. And you can go ahead and put that down. And if you can see, you can kind of see.
And the longer it dries, the more sparkle comes out.
Yeah, right now you're seeing some of that wet formula. That's that white look there. But that'll dry perfectly clear. And then you'll be left with all these. Can you catch those in the light? All that beautiful. So that's the ultra fine sparkle. Just like that. So that's how you use it as a sealer or as a top coat. You do not need another sealer on top of that. I mean, you could put gloss over it, but it's so shiny. You don't need to.
No. So here's a couple other projects.
Oh yeah, this is so cute. Look at this globe. And everyone's altering globes. It's such a fun. You can do all different kinds. Well, with Plaid, you could do chalkboard paints, Mod Podge, anything. But look how cute that is.
And we talked about these cardboard little figurines. Here was one that was a cactus that we just did a little, painted it the way we wanted to, and then added the sparkle right on top of that. And again, this is a great formula for, the sparkle is a great formula just for even very specific areas on your paper.
So I want to show you, don't eat it, Steve, don't eat it.
Mm-mm, not yet.
So I want to show you what just this cupcake topper looks like. So many people, you know, want to do a little customization to a party, but, you know, they're still going to use a store-bought cupcake topper. They may not want to cut this out and all that. And your sparkle and your extreme glitter formulas are going to be perfect for that. All you're going to want to do, just, this is how this started out. Plain, no glitter, no nothing on there. And you just go into wherever you want it and just do a little swoop. This is 2 seconds. Don't worry about if it's chunky in some spots. You'll just have a little bit more glitter there. You can do it thick like that, and then you can thin it out. And then when it dries, it's going to be like that. So if you want to add a little sparkle to a greeting card, a scrapbook page,
here's the better one.
Cupcake topper, whatever you want to do, you can always just take your extreme glitter and your sparkle formula and add it to any paper project.
There you go.
I've done it on gift wrap before, too.
Yeah.
So that is our 5 glitter formulas.
Yes.
Mega, extreme, and sparkle.
Yeah. And don't forget, it is National Mod Podge Month.
Yep.
May 18th is National Mod Podge Day. We want you to send a photo to Instagram, hashtag it National Mod Podge Day. And then you can win prizes, yep, and you will be notified via Instagram.
So all month long, there'll be random drawings. It's open to U.S. residents, 18 only on Instagram. And Plaid's arranging all of the winners and how you'll get your prizes. Now, there's a couple other things that are important to say. All month long, Facebook Lives going on, Instagram stories and pictures with all your Mod Podge inspiration. And there's going to be a giant mega sale at plaidonline.com for National Mod Podge Day. And I believe that's happening on May 18th. There should be a link below in this written in here. And if you click that link, it will take you to all the information about National Mod Podge Day and the sales that might be happening and all the different products that you've seen here.
A lot going on in May.
It's a big deal.
It's a big month.
Mod Podge is, well, 50 plus.
We 50 turned 50 plus years last old, year. Yeah.
We
yeah.
didn't.
We look good.
Mod Podge. I'm getting close. So we started out with the original formulas of matte and gloss, and now we have grown to
big family.
21 different formulas plus accessories.
Yes.
And yeah, so you can get it in a 2 ounce bottle all the way up to, what do we have here?
The big giant gallons.
Boom, boom, boom. A big giant gallon.
The
this
big
is how
gallon.
We roll.
There we go.
Look, it's all messy. It's not very camera ready.
Well, I think we did pretty good today, Kat.
Yeah. No mess glittering.
No mess glittering. Go to Plaid Online.
Yeah.
And get some of this stuff. I think you'll be very happy with some of your projects. And it's fun stuff to work with.
Thank you so much for joining us. We will have a copy of this on YouTube so you can catch it. And you can always catch it on Facebook. And
yes,
we'll be back here very soon with a new Facebook Live.
And send in your photos to Instagram. We want to see them. Take care, guys.
Thanks for joining us.
Bye.